Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the regular Stanley County Board of Commissioners meeting on August the 6th at 7 o'clock. Appreciate everyone coming, especially the media. At this time, let us have invocation and bow our heads in prayer, please. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, give rest to the weary. Bless the dying, soothe the suffering, comfort the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake. Amen. Let us pledge allegiance now. On the agenda, we need to add an item. It'd be on the radio systems. We'll change that, be item 6, and change the consent agenda to item 7. Are there any other changes? If not, I'll entertain a motion to accept the agenda as changed. Hello. Motion made by Commissioner McIntyre for approval and seconded by Vice Chairman Donovan. All in favor, say aye. Motion carried. Thank you very much. First item is SCUSA Transportation Services. Presenter is Gwen Henson.
Good evening. I'm here to talk about the FY 14-15 ROPE allocation, or the Rural Operating Assistance Program. DOT was a little late in issuing this year because of the state budget. It was not approved by July 1st. So they couldn't send it out until they had their line items and their departmental budget approved. So we have been operating under this budget since July 1st, and these funds are retroactive back to July 1st. So what we've spent, we can go back, account back to this grant application. There are three components of the application. One is the Elderly and Disabled Transportation Assistance Program. It's 100% state money, and the county is due to receive $62,998. The second component is the Work First Employment Assistance Program. This is also 100% state funds, and the county is to receive $19,066. And the third component is the Rural General Public. This is 90% state funds, 10% local match. However, a match will be collected by passenger fares. So the total the county is to receive is $151,103, and there will be no request for any local match. I'll be glad to answer any questions.
Anyone have any questions, Ben? If not, I'll declare the public hearing open at this time. Anyone want to speak for or against, come forward. Seeing none, I declare the public hearing closed. What's the pleasure of the board?
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we apply and receive these funds, the ROPE funds from the state federal government.
Motion made by Commissioner McIntyre for approval. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Morton. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Next item is the, it is the library. Excuse me, we got another one. Updates from the NCOD required. I'm sorry about leaving you
that's
out,
okay. Gwen.
You,
that's
you up
okay.
Here twice. I'm sorry.
That's okay. Not usually here but once, so that's okay. The DOT requires us to have a system safety plan in place, and of course we would. However, they have a lot of components that we are required to put into that plan, and that plan is in this notebook. But each year, anything that we change, amend, add a new policy to, or whatever, we're required to bring it before this board for approval. Just a couple highlights on what we've done during this year is I've developed and implemented a lockout tagout program for our vehicle maintenance. We've added a policy on a lift utilization with safety cones. What this means it was if a vehicle is out on the street and the passenger is letting out on the street, then we're now putting the orange safety cones a certain feet from the lift so that people can't get up too close to the passenger, or they can't park so close behind us that we can't get the person in the wheelchair back into the vehicle when it's time to go. We've added the test refusal list from the substance abuse policy in this plan. We've added a facility inspection, safety inspection policy that we do once a month. That's part of this plan now. And we've also updated our maintenance shop inspection form. And then there's a few other little things, grammatical errors and that kind of thing that we've corrected and added to the plan. So I'll be glad to answer any questions.
Thank you, Gwen. Anybody wants
to see anything out of the book,
I'd be glad to show you that.
But these are the updates that we've made or changed to the plan for this year.
Thank you, Gwen. Anyone have any questions? What's the pleasure of the board?
I make a motion we approve the updates as they were presented.
Motion made by Commissioner Shuto for approval. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner McIntyre was first, I believe. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Thank you, Gwen.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to thank Gwen for serving as the chair of the RPO TCC. I don't know whether you guys know that she's doing that right now, but she is, and I know that that's an added thing, but it also provides a lot of support for the TAC meetings, and certainly appreciate what you do.
Thank you.
Next item is for the library. Melanie, you're up.
Good evening. First of all, I'm here to request permission to form a committee to conduct a feasibility study for using the City Hall Annex building as a museum building. I have with me this evening many members of the Historical Society and the board chair. What we would like to do is we have started some preliminary discussions with City Manager Ray Allen. He has briefly talked to the mayor, Ronnie Michaels. They are very open to discussing the county and the museum leasing that City Hall Annex building for a museum. The museum, as you know, has had ongoing problems with the roof, which Jerry has worked very diligently on trying to stop leakings. We've also discovered some under the floor seepage. The cement foundation floor has cracked, and so we're getting some water seepage in there. Most of all, we're really out of space for holding exhibits. We had to have an ambulance gurney in there a couple weeks ago, and there's just not a lot of room in there to maneuver around. I don't know that we'd, I think we could fit a wheelchair person in there to maneuver around, but it's really tight in there. And we're also really low on storage space. We are actually storing some of our items over at the old fire department. So, the idea is to take a look at that City Hall Annex space and see if it would fit our needs. We'd like to have a committee that would consist of representatives from the library and the museum. That's probably myself and Julie Hawks, our museum manager, Historical Society board members, a county commission representative, if you would so like to appoint somebody, and then some folks from the City Hall or the City Council, as they would so choose to appoint. The areas that we want to study are how many dollars we would need to put into the building. Part of the air conditioning units do not work, so that would be an expense. We would need to do some sort of architectural drawings to look at the space and how we would want it fixed up. But there's some flooring replacement that would have to be done and some general painting. So we want this committee to take a look and study for all those costs. We would also need to determine how much of that building we would actually need to use so that we could just rent from the city the space that we needed. And then, of course, we would need to discuss with the city what sort of costs for renting that space we would incur, plus additional utilities expenses for heating and lighting of a larger space. and a couple of code and fire issues we would need to discuss with David Harrington and the fire inspector, just to make sure that we could use that building for our intended purposes. So that's what we would like this committee to do. So we're just at this point requesting permission to go ahead and form that committee.
What's the pleasure of the board?
Can I ask a question, please? I have no problem with, because I know it needs to be done. Is proximity to the library a problem? I mean, as far as the distance away from the library up to the city annex?
The city annex is approximately the same distance as the museum building.
I think you answered the question I had about whether you're going to try to look at the whole building or just part of it, and obviously you don't want to go upstairs in the annex building. That would be
because there's no passenger elevator,
right.
So we would discuss that with David Harrington.
Right. Okay. And has there been any conversation with the city already to just the possibility of doing that?
Very preliminary discussions. Before we went any further, we wanted to make sure that we had your approval.
Right. Mr. Chairman, for no more questions, I'd just make a motion that we give them permission to form the committee and do the feasibility study.
Motion made by Commissioner McIntyre for forming a committee and seconded by Commissioner Esciuto. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
I got a question too now for the board. Do we want to go ahead and appoint a member to that committee now? I would suggest we do while we're here. That's what I was going to recommend.
I'll do it.
Commissioner McIntyre's volunteered. You just let him do it. You got the job.
Okay, the next item. Unfortunately, Dr. Nayland Mehta has rotated off our Library Board of Trustees, and so we need to appoint a replacement for him. We would like to recommend Shirley Hatley. Ms. Hatley is from the Locust area and has many years of experience in the education system, which we think would go well with what we do at the library. So I am asking the board today to appoint Mrs. Shirley Hatley to our Library Board of Trustees.
I make a motion we approve Shirley.
Motion.
Second.
Motion made by Commissioner McIntyre to approve Shirley Hatley, seconded by Commissioner Morton. All in favor say aye. Motion carried. Thank you, Melanie.
Thank you.
Next item on the agenda is the environmental health amendments for fee schedule. David Ezell. Good evening, David.
I do apologize for having to come back to you about fee schedule again. We received notification mid-August from the North Carolina State Lab of Public Health that they were increasing the fees for our water sample supplies. That's the containers, the kits that we use to collect the water and then ship back to the lab. As you can see in the attachments, it's a considerable increase. Anywhere from, I think on page four, close to a 200% increase, almost a 2,000% increase in the cost. This, I believe, came from a legislative mandate that the state lab become financially sustainable. The only fee that is not increasing, in 2008, when the state adopted the private drinking water well program, the lab was given a directive to, because part of that program is we have to collect water samples, that the water samples for new wells had to be at cost, actually the cost of the kit, the cost of lab time, staff time, etc. That one's not increasing, but everything else that we collect or taking is increasing. The list of water samples is quite a bit longer than what you'll see on page four, which are the typical samples that we've been collecting for years. We felt like since these are all the different samples that we can submit to the lab, that since we need to have a fee on the schedule in order to charge for it, we needed to go ahead and put everything in there that we could potentially submit a sample for. The costs that are represented on this, the proposed fee schedule, includes the cost of the supplies, a minimal amount of our staff time, and then shipping back to the lab.
Anyone have any questions?
That's it. We don't have a choice. These fees actually became effective September 1st. I'm sorry? Well, no, you know, our cost of the samples, we haven't ordered any. When we got the email, it was around August 15th. It's dated the 13th. I think it was Wednesday of that week I got onto the state lab's website and thought, we'll see if I can go ahead and get some stuff in. It was gone. I mean, everything that was listed was at the fee that you're seeing on the schedule. Wasn't even able to order anything. Tried to get in under the wire, but I couldn't.
Anyone have any questions? What's the pleasure of the board?
I recommend we go ahead and adjust these fees as proposed. I don't see that we have any choice if it's mandated by the state.
Second.
Motion made by Vice Chairman Donovan for approval, seconded by Commissioner McIntyre. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Thank you.
Next item is the presentation of the Stanley County Farm Bureau proposal for the naming rights of proposed livestock arena. Andy Lucas.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, and Candace is here as well as some of the members of the Farm Bureau. You have the proposal in front of you for the $250,000 gift, and terms and conditions would be a 50-year naming right proposal. And there's some other stipulations in terms of how quickly or how the money would be dispersed and how quickly, and also some stipulations around when in terms of breaking ground. And I think certainly the Farm Bureau just doesn't want us holding on to their money. And what I told them is we wouldn't draw down their money until we actually needed it. We wouldn't take their money and hold on to it until we actually need it for construction or any kind of civil work at the site. And so this is a little, their proposal in terms of the number of years exceeds what the board had sort of set out as guidelines in the RFP. And so I think, and I've had a conversation with Candace and some of the members of the Farm Bureau, and it's very certainly a gracious gift, and we don't want to look a gift horse in the mouth. At the same time, and what I tried to explain to them was, you know, 20 years from now, we're going to be in a situation where we're going to have to get into another capital campaign in order to fix roofs, HVAC systems, and other things, and we're going to need significant gifts again, probably to help with that. And so I think they're open to having a discussion about the 50-year term. So what I recommended is maybe getting a group of commissioners, two commissioners, to sit down and meet with Candace and I and members of the Farm Bureau and see if we can't iron out a way to bridge the gap between sort of the board's expectation of naming rights and terms and what the Farm Bureau is seeking, because we certainly want to try to work with them and work something out. And I think they're amenable to that conversation and seeing if we can't find a way to come up with a term that works for them and their fiduciary responsibility, but also for us and our needs moving forward. So that's what I would recommend, and certainly I'd be open to Candace if you have anything to add. You've been working more closely on this than I have. I'd be open to that.
Well, I think it's a good idea for two of us commissioners to go sit down and talk with them and come to some type of agreement. We know what we want, they know what they want, so there's got to be some middle ground somewhere. So let's don't throw the baby out with the bathwater.
When I saw this, I couldn't imagine any better group that I'd like to have the naming rights for. But when I also looked at it, I thought we had talked about limiting the number of years. And so I really would like to have a couple of commissioners do some negotiating and see if we couldn't, as Andy said, get it closer to where we might need to have money in the future that Mike could address that. But I know some folks are here tonight from Farm Bureau or representing them, so I'd like to say thanks for your interest in it, and hopefully we can work something out.
I got a quick question. How much was the total cost of the project? Was it like $850,000, a million?
The projected cost at this time is about $750,000, and that's building in a considerable amount of site work, grading that will have to be done, in parking areas, all of that's included. I mean, naturally, the number could go up or down depending on the precise location of the building, but that's the ballpark figure we're working with.
So with our $250,000, that $250,000, that's two-thirds of it. Have you had any other donations?
We actually have several in the works. Couple of major gifts in the realm of $25,000 to $75,000. In all candor, they are waiting until the naming rights are worked out, as that will sort of dictate the tone of the way the other agreements are worked out. So we're excited about all of those. I would like to add that a group of us from the Arena Steering Committee are going to meet with Commissioner Steve Troxler November 5th, I believe. Chairman Dennis will be attending with us. And so we hope to get some kind of support from the state as well. Timing is good. I would like to add that the Farm Bureau annual meeting is the third Thursday in October. So we'd like to respectfully request that the working session occur before the Farm Bureau annual meeting so they can give an update to their membership. October 16th.
I'll be glad to serve as one. Who else would like to serve with me? Vice Chairman? Okay. I've got Vice Chairman. They said they'd like him to serve. All right.
Thank you.
If that's okay with everybody? Consent on that? Okay. Well, we'll meet whenever y'all
great
need to meet.
Thank you. We'll coordinate something in the next couple of weeks.
Okay. We'll just work it out.
Thank you. And I would like to add a big thank you to the Farm Bureau. They've been very supportive and patient as we've worked our way through this process. It's a precedent-setting situation for us, so they've been extremely patient and cooperative.
Yes.
So we have several members here.
Yes.
Charles Herlocker, Keith Hill, and Andrew Burleson are all here.
Well,
so
I'd
like to
thank
to
them all, too, because it's
okay.
A very generous gift.
Thank you.
Next item on the agenda is the information related to town hall meetings regarding the sales tax referendum. Commissioner Asciutto.
Yes, just want to update everybody. I know I've mentioned in the past that I was trying to put together some town hall meetings throughout the county. And I've set up five of them in the different parts. And they're going to start the 13th. We're going to have one in Richfield, and I'm going to invite officials from New London and Meisenheimer in case they want to join. You know, join the town hall meeting in 10:14, the 14th. We're going to have it in Albemarle at on 10:15. That's on Wednesday. We're going to have it in Locust, and we're going to invite folks from Stanfield and Red Cross in case some of those officials want to show up. And then on 10:27, we're going to have it in Norwood at Norwood Town Hall. I'm going to also invite the Oakboro City officials. And of course, the 16th, we're going to have it in Baden. I skipped a date there. Sorry. And the purpose of these is, actually, there's quite a few purposes of it. One is, you know, I've always felt the need to be open with the people how their tax dollars are being spent. And I have that presentation I've done over the last year on Stanley County tax dollars at work to show, you know, the work days I've had in Stanley County, explain a little to people where the tax dollars go. I also plan on talking about the quarter cent sales tax referendum and hopefully trying to get the positive about that, and also want to have the city officials there and possibly some school board members, because I'm going to be at the school board meeting tomorrow night talking about the quarter cent sales tax referendum. I'm going to invite them, and I'm going to invite the citizens to come out to these things, and hopefully they come out and learn a little about local government, plus to give us feedback and ask questions. They may have some questions about the county or these municipalities that hopefully we can answer, and if we can't answer, we could get back to them, because I think it's good to have a good give and take, and any of the fellow commissioners are more than welcome to show up and let me know in advance if you can, because if we have more than two there, then we have to go through the, you know, the proper public notices and stuff like that, and probably to have someone there to take notes. And I want to tell the same things to the municipalities too, remind them about, you know, they could have whoever they want there, but if they get more than the quorum, they probably have to check with their things. But that's about it. And basically, the I'm just going to go give them information and just answer any questions they may have.
Anyone got any questions?
So these aren't the scheduled regular meetings of the councils. These are different dates than that?
Correct. These are completely different dates than when the regular council meets. Okay. So this, the whole purpose is it's like just a town hall meeting.
Are you going to restrict your comments to the, I'm concerned about on the sales tax referendum, and I had a problem with that, but it says other community concerns. What are you restricting your comments to on those matters?
I have no restrictions.
You what?
There are no restrictions.
There are no restrictions?
They can talk about anything they want, and I can talk about whatever I want. And just to let you know that every time, and I've done these things for about a year, I've been to every, past 2 years, I've been to every town council meeting in the municipality. This year, I've been to all of them except for three. But I always preface it, when I ever have an opinion, I say, this is my opinion. It may not be represent the entire board's opinion, but this is how I feel. But there are no limits to what we, what's on the agenda. Whatever people want to come talk about, they may have a, because I know I always talk about animal control. You know, I talk about in that taxpayer dollars of work, I show a little video and I talk about school safety. I've talked about school safety at these things over the last year or so. Whatever folks want to talk about, because it's their tax dollars that are being spent. And I always feel there should be good open flow between the taxpayers and the people who spend their tax dollars.
Anyone else?
I just comment that, prefacing your comments with the fact that it's your part, most of it. The referendum sales tax, obviously we voted on that, and it wouldn't be on the ballot if we didn't all approve to that. But, and prefacing that with that comment is great. And also, you can't control what people are going to ask. And so you can just answer it, as your personal own opinion. And if it's something we voted on, then you can say, the commissioners voted to do so-and-so. So I don't have a problem with that.
Yeah, I think I'm creating a lot of work for myself doing this.
Knock yourself out.
By the way, I know. But it's something I always thought was a good idea over the summer. And I actually talked to municipalities about this over the summer. But, of course, the medical thing came up, and I couldn't do it over the summertime. And with the quarter-cent sales tax, I did want to get it in before the election. I think the only one I wasn't able to schedule before the early voting started was the one in Norwood. But I am very much aware that the only thing we talk about is consensus of the board has voted on is with the quarter-cent sales tax. And everything else, I always say I'm only one of five, but here's my opinion, stuff like that. But like I said, any of y'all are welcome to come by, just let me know, and I'll announce that also.
Well, I think it would be good, if you had two of us there, or and Andy attend as many as he could, maybe, and because maybe a question come up that he could provide some feedback.
I'm going to try to get town officials there, city officials, and us there. I just hope people show up. That's my big thing, is getting the citizens to show up, and hope they show up.
Thank you very much. We're ready for the next item. The next item is the radio system refinancing and related items.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. We just have a couple loose ends to tie up on the refinancing for we're refinancing. Last time at the September 2nd meeting, you all approved sending a resolution to the LGC to refinance through the Bank of North Carolina our existing lease purchase agreement with Motorola, and to get some additional financing for the radios that we still need to purchase. The bank has asked for a more specific authorizing resolution approving them as the bank for that financing agreement. And so that's in this packet, as well as they've asked us to assign an existing easement with the city of Albemarle for the Tuckertown radio site. And that's just really to secure their lien, because with installment financing, a little different than a bond where you're pledging tax revenue, property tax, and then installment financing, you're pledging the asset. And so they need to have that easement for the real property as part of that lien. So those are the two items we're asking you to consider this evening. And then the assignment to easement was still in draft form, and our attorney's been going back and forth, and so all we would ask you is to authorize staff to negotiate any changes to the assignment of easement in the best interest of the county. And so those are the three actions we're seeking for the board related to that item. I'd be more happy to answer any questions.
Anyone have any questions, Andy? What's the pleasure of the board? Can we do all three of them in one?
You can do all three of them as long as you realize that, that you don't state that, you know.
Yeah, state all three of them. Mm-hmm.
Mr. Chair, I'd make a motion that we approve all three of these items, that we consider, that we approve the resolution authorizing a new financing agreement, that we approve the easement assignment granting Bank of North Carolina rights, and also that we authorize staff to negotiate changes to the resolution assignment of easement.
Motion made for approval from Vice Chairman Donovan. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Shuto. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Thank you all.
Next item
on the agenda is the consent agenda. Well, I'll entertain a motion to approve the consent agenda as presented.
I just have a question.
Yes, go right ahead.
Are we seeing more refunds on vehicle taxes collected now than we did when we did it ourselves? I mean, I know our collection rate's up, but it seems like every month we've got a list, and this month we've got one in there for almost $3,000. And I don't understand, and maybe I'm not supposed to, but it just seems kind of odd that I don't remember seeing this many before, and I could be wrong.
One of the reasons was before you were actually supposed to see them, and we weren't bringing those to you, and general statute sort of provides some additional guidance. And so Ford hadn't been doing that for on vehicles for as long as we can remember, and now we've done that. And you all passed a resolution, and I think it's over a certain amount. If it's under a certain amount, then we take care of it. But if it's over a certain amount, the other thing is that they're having some issues with this new system in terms of the situs of where they establish the where that vehicle is supposed to be, and so it's defaulting to Albemarle. And you know, that's probably if it's going to default anywhere, that's the best place to do it because that's where the largest number of people live, and the chances are it's going to be there. But in fact, somebody from the Department of Revenue was here last week or the week before and worked both with the license plate agency, because a lot of the issues we were having is we were sending the situs to them as correct, and then when it got over there, somehow it wasn't coming out correctly. And so this individual from the Department of Revenue came down and has assisted them with some things and changing their process, but has also assisted us in some things we can do with change our process. So hopefully we don't have as many of these issues where it's being the wrong situs has happened, and then they paid their taxes, you know, and they don't live in Albemarle, they live in New London, and they paid the wrong amount of tax because of the difference between New London's tax rate and Albemarle's tax rate, and having to give them a refund. So that's really why you're seeing more, is this new system has had an issue, a little glitch, and we're hoping to work through that and eliminate those in the future.
Thank you. Just a question.
What's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion to approve.
Motion made by Commissioner McIntyre for approval. Do I hear a second? Seconded by Vice Chairman Donovan. All in favor say aye. Motion carried. Well, we'll come to this part. It's public comment. Anyone like to come speak to the commissioners about anything, come forward at this time. General, I'm going to start with you, Commissioner McIntyre.
No comment. No comment.
Commissioner Morton?
No comment.
Vice Chairman?
The sales tax has been mentioned, and I would just encourage citizens of Stanley County to pay attention to that. Stanley County has on the ballot a sales tax referendum for November the 4th. Ours is different from some of our neighboring counties, so I would just encourage people to pay attention, and to when you go to our website and get information. And also, it has been a group that is trying to make sure the information gets out. So. So as Commissioner McIntyre indicated, we voted for it, we support it, but we'll be providing more information as time goes along. So just ask people to pay attention to that.
Mr. Shuto.
Okay, three quick things. First of all, at these town meetings, if anyone wants to show up and do one, y'all can do one. And I could just, you know, I talk enough during the day, I can take use a break sometimes, and people could use a break from listening to me too. So if anyone wants to do that, I'm more than happy to work with them on different, you know, they can handle that one town meeting, I'd be there, but they up with questions and stuff. Also, just want to update people on animal control. There was a story on the news about 3 or 4 weeks ago about a house where they found 22 dog carcasses there, and they're still kind of, the police are still investigating it. And what it looks like at this point, according to, you know, from talk to Dennis Joyner about it, you know, they went to the gentleman moved about a year and a half ago. They hadn't had any complaints in that place in the last really 2 years for them to go out. So they went to the new place, just did a quick surprise visit on him. The gentleman who was at the place that moved, he rescues animals, and the place was good up there. There were no problems with the animals up there in Richfield where he's at. And they're thinking what might have happened is people were used to dropping off animals at his house and leaving them there. And once he moved, they're thinking that's possibly what happened. People were bringing animals there for him to rescue, and nobody, he wasn't living there anymore. So that's kind of where they're at in the investigation right now. So that's one of those unfortunate things. But I know Animal Control said they hadn't had a call there in the last 2 years to check on that place in the last 2 years. Then next thing, third thing, just want to, you know, I was down at the scene in Albemarle when they had the shooting last week, and I just want to say, give a good shout out to Dr. Terry Griffin, to Rick Burris, to Bill Halliburton, and all the folks that responded. I know you can't prevent everything, but it's how you respond. Especially want to thank the school teachers. They had those kids calm and, you know, as calm as it could be under the circumstances, and they were all professionals. I mean, I know that Rick, Sheriff Burris, he had a drill at Albemarle over the summertime. They did a drill for such this type of occasion, and he's also talking about doing drills at all the other high schools and all the other middle schools, just to make sure that people have a layout of the land and the way the schools are and stuff. And that was just a tragedy, and hope the kids, one kid that was shot, I hope he's okay and his family. And I just can't say enough about how Dr. Griffin and the school teachers and the emergency management folks responded to everything. And that's all. That's all I got.
Andy?
No comment, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Attorney?
No comment. Thank you, sir.
Good. Well, I'll entertain a motion that we go into closed session to discuss economic development in accordance with GS 143-318.11, little a in parentheses, 4 in parentheses.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Motion made by Vice Chairman Donovan, seconded by Commissioner McIntyre. All in favor say aye. We're in closed session. We got to recess too.